about turning his life around and having a second chance at life and making it mean something and being there for one's children and for one's family. So I'm just so happy, excited for Shannon. I'm happy and excited for his grandmother, who I was able to hug, and I'm happy for his kids, and I'm just very hopeful that they're, this is a turning point, and there's great things coming in the future.
Max, is this a fair and just verdict, do you think?
Absolutely. Absolutely. The jurors, we asked so much of the jurors, and they really scrutinized the evidence, and they demanded real evidence, and it wasn't there. And so we are thankful for the jurors, and it's just a great day.
Did you have a chance to talk to the jurors?
I did, and I'm not going to comment on the discussions with the jurors, but I will just say I think the fact that they deliberated for 4 days, and also that just the amount of time that they put in, they certainly scrutinized everything, and they did their jobs as jurors, and we are appreciative of that and so thankful.
Can you reiterate again what he was only found guilty on one charge and what that means for the future, him getting released, all that stuff?
So he was found guilty of possession of a firearm on March 17th, not the day of any of any other crimes. It was the day that he was arrested.
Okay.
And there was a gun that was registered to his girlfriend that was found near the scene of where he was arrested. And that's what he was convicted of. Judge Whitaker, we are so thankful to her for having an open mind. A lot of times when you take a case to trial, you just get the maximum sentence for daring to take on the state. Judge Whitaker did not see it that way. She gave Mr. Stillwell a time served sentence for the time that he has served, followed by probation. Mr. Stillwell has a couple, or I think one other criminal matter that needs to be resolved. I am hopeful and optimistic. It's nothing like this case. It's just it's a case that was picked up while incarcerated. And we're hopeful that there will be a quick resolution to that case, and Mr. Stillwell will be able to get back to his life and his children and his family.
You think he'll be home by Christmas? Is that
I'm hoping. Okay. That's not unrealistic.
I know you don't want to get into exactly what the jurors said, but what do you think their one sticking point was?
I don't think there was one sticking point. I don't think there was. You know, so many people have been watching this case. You know, in opening, I said from the beginning about the witnesses in blue suits and wearing the Fulton County blues. And I think the world got to see how cases can be built the wrong way, just finding people that are prone to lie and talking to them at their most desperate time to try to get them to say things about other people. And I think that's what happened here, and I think the jurors recognize that. And of course, regarding the 2022 case, that was on video, and I think we explained what we saw in the video, and I think the jurors likely saw the same thing.
What kind of message should this verdict send to the taxpayers of Fulton County?
Oh, I don't know about all that. The message that was sent to me is my client has a second chance at life, and we're just so thankful for that. And I know he is. And we are also just so thankful to the press for covering this, and all the people that at some point the public began to root for us, and that did make a difference, and we appreciate all the people that have been supporting us throughout this process, this long journey.
Can you speak to the conditions of the jail?
I mean, and I don't mean to, we know that Shannon was stabbed in the stomach earlier in this trial, while this trial was going on. We know we had to break for a week, or at least a week, might have been 2 weeks for his recovery. I was the only person allowed to go see him in the hospital. And so that was, you know, and then Mr. Kendrick was stabbed in the head recently. So obviously those are serious, and we got to make sure we take care of people, especially people that are not even convicted of anything. And so that's I think it's something we need to address. I'm not blaming any particular person, but it's something as a society and as a city we need to take care of.
Reaction, what happened?
You know, Deamonte and I were—I want to say—we were surprised because, given that the jury had clearly been looking at all the evidence, we thought that this was the only outcome they could really come to. But nevertheless, we were thrilled. Just—he's been—he's looking forward to getting out, getting back to his music, getting back to his family, all the supporters he's had, all the prayers, all the love—it's been wonderful. And I didn't say this earlier to everybody else, but I've got to thank Judge Whitaker. The entire case changed when she took over. We got a fair trial. And anyway, it's just a wonderful experience. Sir, absolutely. Thank you.